Hi, my sweet and little hearts. Okay, welcome back. Okay, almost you are there in end of the third chapter. In this video, we are going to finish this chapter. And I hope you all are enjoying these videos and understanding these videos. Now, see children, in the last video, we have discussed the only one left part of the second chapter, that is fruit, flower and the seeds. And even we have discussed the eating habits of the animals. There are three categories, carnivore, herbivore and omnivorous type of animals are there. We have discussed these all very brief, and even we know the example for this also. So in this video, we are going to start with how do animals eat. As we know that categorize the animals into three types, and even we can see there are lot many different types of animals. They have different type of mouth, the face structure is different in size, shape, color, isn't it? Then how do they are going to eat? We are not going to name animals as Rakesh, Rohan, Preeti like this, but we can categorize the animals how do they eat depending upon their eating style. Okay. Then the first step or first type is swallowing the food, whole food they are going to swallow. So swallowing means suddenly there is an animal which will come into your mind, that is snake. The snake, as soon as it see the any frog or some other food animals or food material, so it is going to swallow the whole food because it doesn't have the teeth to bite and chew and make it juice and next to swallow. It has the habit of swallowing the whole food. That may be the frog, that may be the yak, that may be the other animal, small animal. So whatever it may be, even the human, for human body also it is going to swallow. Anaconda and python are there, no? They are going to swallow the whole animal, bigger animals. They will swallow inside. Then after swallowing, when it enters their body, they will start crushing that. They will start making like this their whole body. So that whatever has entered the animal inside their body, so it should become the very it should break down, and from there only it should start the digestion. So this is what the snake and the frog, it is going to swallow the whole insect. Frog has a long sticky tongue, lizard. They are going to swallow the whole food, and inside when it animal will go inside, there only the digestion takes place. Then next one is sucking the food. There are some animals, that may be the small or that may be the big. They have the habit of sucking. Sucking means how do you suck the juice, how do you suck the milkshake. So like this, they have the sucking habit. For example, mosquito honeybee and butterfly, what they will do, they don't have bigger mouth or teeth and all. They have one needle, small sharp needle like structure, one like pipe will be there, and wherever they will go, if they want to suck the blood, now mosquito, how it is going to suck the blood? So like the small tube like needle like structure will be there, they will bite there and they will suck. Even the butterfly, even the honeybee, these all are the example where sucking the food is going to take place. And then we have biting and chewing. Biting and chewing means there are some animals which are going to bite them, even the human body. We will bite the food and we will chew the food. Along with us, we will get some other animals too. Cow, ox, buffalo and the horse and the goat. Some animals are there. Even squirrel, rabbit, rat, even these animals are also, they will bite first. Even we are also going to bite first in the mouth, then we are going to chew in the mouth, and we will make a paste of that one and we are going to swallow it. So these are the some type of animals where biting takes place, then chewing of the food takes place. Next we have, that is last, that is tearing and cutting the food. Yes, you can see it. The tearing and cutting the food means first comes here lion, tiger, leopard and the cheetah. Next sometimes dog also. So they have very sharp teeth here. They will tear the flesh of other animals first and then they will start cutting it small, I mean in the mouth itself. They will tear the part, then they will make the small parts. I mean, in the mouth only, they will make small one part of that body. They will start cutting and then they will swallow. So this is what another type of the, how do the animals eat. So this is what the four different types: swallowing the food whole, sucking the food, biting and chewing, and tearing the food, and tearing and cutting the food. So children, we have learned the different type of animals, and even with examples, which type of animals are going to eat this type of food, which type of animals are going to suck the food, which type of animals are biting and chewing along with the human body, and which type of animals tearing and cutting the food they are going to do. We have learned this one. Then we have some other animals too. I don't know, in the first, second standard you might have learned domestic animals, wild animals, you may remember this one. But domestic animals are very much helpful for us. They will live with us, and they were helping us in many ways. Okay. And some domestic animals we can keep in our house also, and we can make a separate house for them also. For example, cow, dog, and ox, and the goat, these all are the domestic animals. Where we know that we are getting help from those animals, for those animals even we should provide some uses or some help. So then how do we take care of those animals? See, this domestic animals, in this again we have feeding habit. Like cow gives us a milk, goat give us a milk, buffalo give us a milk. Then how do we can take care of those animals? So we can first give them food and water. For them also they need food to survive themselves. We have to provide food and water, then shelter. For the animals, food, water, and the shelter. For them we have to build a small like shed like house where they can stay there. Time they can stay there in that place. Next we have to clean them, their bodies, and even their shelter. Whatever we have prepared, small house like for them, we have to clean, maintain that one, always clean. Then if they are not well, if they are sick, we have to go for treatment. We should treat them, the sick animals, domestic feeding animals. Next, we should be very kind. We should be very we should show courtesy on them, and we should not hurt them. We should not tease them, always hurting, pinching them, always doing like this, hurting them, and making while they are eating. If we are teasing them while they are drinking water, if we are teasing them, then it may hurt for them. They will not live with us. They will run away from us. So we should take care of the feeding habit domestic animals, because we have lot many uses from those animals. This is what the whole third chapter ends here. Children, I hope you all have understood whatever we have discussed for this chapter. And before ending, I would like to give you homework. That is, how do animals eat? How do animals eat? Explain with different types. These four types you have to explain. Then how do we take care of feeding habit of domestic animals? How do we can take care of domestic animals also will come, or feeding habit domestic animals also you can. Three most important questions are there. After this you can go for solving the exercise. Okay, I hope you can enjoy this video, and you can enjoy by doing this all work. If you not understood, see the video again and again and go for understanding this one, because it's very easy. You can understand if you are concentrating in the studies. I hope you will do this homework. And let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.